the Lord. You're welcome to tonight's radio program called Be Inspired by the City of Light Evangelical Ministries, based in Leytonstone, 159 Coward Road, Leytonstone, E111JD. We're recording live from www.mysweetfm.com, a radio station based here in London. Please call your friends, WhatsApp them, SMS them, and tell them your radio pastor is on tonight once again. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you as you stay in tune with us on this live program. Remember the telephone numbers to call tonight. You can call 075-555-988-739. You can call 075-555-988-739 or 023-519-7611 or text live on 60777 for more information. I believe that tonight the Lord will minister to us lively and you'll be inspired. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you for the divine privilege to be on air once again. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Daddy, for your word that is sharper than a two-edged sword. I pray, Lord, as we share word this evening, men and women will rise up to their destinies again in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for the divine privilege. Thank you for the blood of the Lamb. Thank you for divine access. And thank you, Daddy, for mysweetfm.com. That's been a blessing to City of Light Evangelical Ministries. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Last week, Friday, we shared on some great topic. And tonight, again, we're here again to share with you on another great topic called Dream Again. Last week, we shared on purpose. For this purpose. The Bible says, for this purpose, was the Son of Man made manifest to destroy the work of the enemy. So in life, everyone has a purpose. And your purpose on earth shall be met in Jesus' name. Tonight, I'm sharing with you Dream Again. And I'm going to tell you that you need to dream. Your future needs a dream. Hear me tonight. Your future, my future, your son's future, your daughter's future. Anybody that's alive today, you need a dream. That future, that career, that business needs a dream. Don't let it go blank. I repeat, that future, that career, that business needs a dream. Don't let it go blank. A wise man said, aim at nothing and hit nothing. If you're not aiming at anything, you're not going to hit anything. Why? Because it is a fruitless effort. You can carry a Dane gun and say going hunting and you just begin to shoot in the air. You don't have any game you're shooting at, you don't have any prey you're shooting at, all you just do is shooting in the air, then you're just aiming at nothing, and you cannot hit anything. I pray tonight that as you hear me, you will aim at something and you hit something. Whatever dreams have been aborted by the enemy, as you listen to me tonight, they will rise up again in Jesus' name. Life is meaningless and set for doom when you have no dream. Life is meaningless and set for doom when you have no dream. Life is meaningless and set for doom when you have no dreams. Hear me. Whatever you are, discover what you want to be. Do you hear that? That wherever you are today, discover what you want to be. It's time to see what you are created to be in life. Whatever you are, discover what you want to be. It's time to see what you are created to be in life. God did not just create you as a non-entity. He created you to be somebody to make impact, to bring purpose and life to your generation. So that you are somebody, and that somebody must come into fruitfulness in Jesus' name. Create or get an expectation or aspiration for your tomorrow. Create or get an aspiration for your tomorrow. Create an expectation for your tomorrow. Your tomorrow shall be colorful. Your tomorrow shall be glorious. But if you don't have an expectation, Bible says the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. So you have an expectation to meet up with. I have a dream. We all know that by Martin Luther King Jr. But hear this tonight. That dream will set pace for your experience. That dream you have will set pace for your experience that you're about to encounter from the very first day you begin to dream. Why you look or seem frustrated in life is because you have no dream. Why most of us feel or seem frustrated in life is because you have no dream. A man or woman who wakes up in the morning and just sits down in the sitting room and begins to look in the air. 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 8:30, let me go to work. Or what am I going to do today? No. For every blessed day, have a dream. For every glorious day, have a dream. Your world is waiting for you to fulfill your dream. Do you hear me tonight? The world is waiting for the manifestations of the sons of God. And it's your dream that the world is waiting for, because you are unique, you're wondrous, you're fearfully and wonderfully made. There are no two kind of you. You are just the perfect person God has created for this our generation. And you will not disappoint heaven in Jesus' name. The book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5 says, before I formed thee in the belly. So before God formed thee in the belly, he says, I knew thee. So God had seen you in heaven and programmed what you need to be on that. So whatever career you're doing that seems is not working out, go back to the designer of your life, because he had known you before you were formed in your mother's belly. He says, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, I prepared you, I programmed you, I fashioned you, I've made you to be that man or woman that I want you to be. And I ordained you for a purpose. For Jeremiah, he had ordained him to be a prophet. For you, he has ordained you to be a businessman or businesswoman. For the other lady, he has ordained you to be a doctor, a nurse. For that other lady or man, listen to me, ordained you to be a teacher. But everybody has a purpose in it. So you are assigned to a generation, and you will not miss out in the middle squares. Dreams are powerful. Are you hearing me tonight? Your dream, my dreams are powerful. I'm going to pray some prayers with you tonight before we commence into the full word. Bible says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the belly, out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee. We're going to pray right now that, Lord, what you have ordained me to be, in case I've missed out. Realign me. Retrace my steps back, O Lord, to my destiny. Open your mouth, I'm going to pray. That, Lord, in case I've missed my program in which you have programmed for me, O Lord, and I've left that program for another program, Lord, reorder my steps back. Open your mouth and pray for yourself. Lord, reorder that sister's steps back. Reorder your son's steps back. Whatever, oh God, they are doing, oh Lord, that is not part of your agenda for the destiny, and they're in it right now, and they're struggling, they feel frustrated, they feel dejected, they feel that heaven has closed the windows upon them, Father, by the blood tonight, reprogram them, reprogram them, reprogram them. That man, that woman, that boy, that girl that seems to be struggling now because they're not doing what you've ordained them to be, Father, I pray tonight, reprogram them. Reprogram them. Have mercy, Lord. Let grace answer for them. Let mercy answer for them. Let your mercy answer for them. Let mercy answer for them. By the blood. By the blood of Jesus Christ. Show forth your mercy. Show forth your compassion. Show forth your mercy. Let grace prevail, Lord. Let grace prevail, Lord. Let mercy prevail, Lord. Reprogram them, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. My original destiny that have been swallowed by wickedness, be vomited out right now. You pray for yourself. My original destiny that the enemy has swallowed, be vomited right now. Open your mouth and pray. My original destiny that the enemy has swallowed due to my days of ignorance, be vomited right now. Yes, pray for yourself. Be vomited right now. Be vomited right now. Be vomited right now. Be vomited. Vomit. 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 Vomit right now. Oh, ye earth, my destiny, my dreams that have been thwarted, that have been frustrated, come again back to life. Open your mouth and pray. Come again back to life. 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 Ibrahoskopiam talibade, rescante, le caros lebalabasha, le camprotose, nits lebrubosaha, delishkleba, dusle lebalaba. Let that dream come again back to life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I see somebody right now, your crown, your glory is restored back to you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As I said earlier, that dreams are powerful. So whatever be your dream, which is according to God's word, He will actualize it today. You hear me? Dreams are powerful. So whatever be your dreams, which according to God's word today, He, our God, will surely actualize it and make it come to pass. Hear me. Nothing can stop a man or a woman who can dream. But do you know that there's someone who can stop that dream from happening? Just look into that screen. You are the only one that can stop that dream from manifesting. You are the only one that can make that dream frustrated. You are the one that can cripple that dream. I want to pray for yourself and put your right hand upon your forehead and say, Lord, I will not terminate the dream you have for me. I will not, O Lord, terminate the dream you have for my destiny. I will not get to heaven and make heaven disappointed because I personally aborted my dream. Open your mouth and pray for yourself. That, Lord, mention your name, I Femi. You mention your name and pray right now that I Femi, O Lord, will not aid the abortion of my dream, my assignment here on earth, Lord. I will fulfill my dream. I will fulfill God's dream for my life. My purpose on earth shall be fulfilled. My dream, the God-given dream for me, I will not abort. I will not abort. I will not abort. I will not allow foolishness. I will not allow friends or families to make me miss my dream. I personally will not be the one to frustrate my dream in my life. I will not, Lord, aid the enemy. I will not, Lord, aid my pastors. I will not aid my friends and my family to abort my dreams, no matter, Lord, who is around me that wants to abort my God-given dreams. Disconnect me from such. Disconnect me from such. Disconnect me, Lord. Disconnect me, Lord. Disconnect me, Lord. Disconnect me, Lord. My friends, my family, people, my colleagues at work will not abort my dreams. I will not also aid the abortion of my dreams. Lord God, my God-given dreams shall rise up again. My God-given dreams shall rise up again. The same God who raised up Christ from the dead shall raise up my dead and sleeping dreams again. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody shout hallelujah. I see your dead dreams coming back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. No matter what you think you're encountering tonight, no matter what you're going through, God is ready to walk with you. Hear me? As I said earlier, nothing can stop a man or a woman who can dream. Only you can, if you don't run with the dream. Bible says, write down the vision, not sleep with it, not keep it on your bed, but he that writes that dream or the vision must run with it. It is your picture of the scriptures, which is the Bible, that determines your future. A picture of the scripture that determines your future. If you don't have a scripture God has given to you concerning that job, concerning that ministry, concerning that career, then you can have a scripture. You need a scripture that determines your future. So you need to make the Bible your best pal. Every scripture determines your future. Whatever you see in the scripture can become a reality. Just believe whatever you see in the scripture can become a reality. Whatever I see in the scripture, whatever you see in the scripture can become a reality. All you need to do is just believe. Shout, I believe. Shout out again, I believe. So just believe. What you dream is what you become. And what you don't dream, you don't get. I can ask you today, what do you see in your future? I'm asking you today, what do you see in your future? We're going to go over the air for a few minutes, and I want you to ponder upon that statement that I made and the question I asked you. What can you see in your future? Stay tuned and ponder upon that great question. Remember, dream again. Radio ministry program from the City of Life Evangelical Ministries based on Lexington E111JD. Your host, Pastor Femi Olowo, tell your friends and families to stay tuned, tune in to www.mysweetfm.com. In Jesus' name we pray. So I'll get back to you shortly. You think about the question I asked you. What do you see in your future? God bless you. Thank you.
I used to think that I could not go on, and life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. If I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. There are miracles in life I must achieve. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Hey, 'cause I believe in you. Oh, if I can see it, then I can do it.
What you don't have a picture, you don't have a future. Until you have a picture of the future, then you don't have a glorious future. A picture of the scripture will determine your future. As we continue tonight, as I said earlier, you need to dream again. Most people don't have any dream. Most men, most women, most boys, most girls just walk the roads of life aimlessly. And why they walk aimlessly is because they don't have a dream for their lives. I pray tonight, once again, that the dream that God has in stock for you from the womb and before he created you in your mother's womb, if that dream is dead, I command the resurrection life to raise it up again. Have a dream for your future. In order for you not just to work for an establishment for 40 years and settle for into retirement, don't just have a program. I'm going to work for a company, and as I work for that company, I'll serve them for 40 years, then I'll retire. That's not a dream. You're just working. I decree tonight that as you settle down to hear this message, your dream, your purpose in life shall be made manifest. Don't just settle into retirement and say that is the end of it. What you see is what you get. Are you hearing me? What I see, what you see, is what you get. If you don't see anything, then you don't get anything. If you don't dream anything, then you don't get any dreams. The layman says, garbage in, garbage out. What's what you do to the computer? So it is what you impute into yourself is what you get back. I repeat myself, if you see nothing, you will get nothing. Your vision tells you where you belong, but your dream determines its existence. Your vision, my vision, tells me where I belong, but my dream determines its existence. Your vision, I repeat, tells you where you belong. But your dream determines the existence of that vision. Your vision shows you what you can become in life. But your dream takes you to the point where you begin to actualize that vision. Your vision shows you what you can become in life. But your dream, hear that, takes you to the point where you begin to actualize that vision. So your dream is a driving force to bring about that vision. Yes, you may have a vision, you want to become an engineer, but if you don't have a dream of you seeing yourself settling down and going back to college or doing some self-studies or personal development, then you would not get to the reality of that vision coming to reality. So your dream is a driving force to bring the vision to come to pass. Your vision is one thing to see beyond the natural. Your vision is one thing, but to see beyond the natural is a dream. I repeat, your vision is one thing, but to see beyond the natural is to dream. Small dreams, no matter how small that dream is, or shall I say, if you narrow your dream, you narrow your destiny. If you belittle your dreams, you belittle your destiny. Your growth is tied to your dreams. Your growth, my growth, is tied to your dreams. If you're a business person, the growth of your business is tied to the depth of your dream. If you're a career person, the growth of your career is tied to the depth of your dream. So what you see or what you dream determines the end result of what you get. God might have proposed for you to be a great distributor. It could be a distributor. But if your dream never goes beyond the small table in East Street Market, God wants to make you a great distributor. But if what you see now or what you are doing now is narrowed to a small table in East Street Market, then you're not fulfilling the great dream that God has purpose for you to fulfill. Your dream never goes beyond what you're doing presently now. You now have to make up your mind and walk towards the fulfillment of that dream. Don't limit the dream that God has in stock for you. There was a great story about a man who went fishing. And anytime he caught a big fish, he threw it back into the river. And the gentleman was watching him and he asked him, "Why are you throwing the big fish back into the river and the small ones you put back in your boat?" He said, "Because I have a small frying pan." Are you that kind of a man? Because you believe that the size of your frying pan determines the fish you catch? It's so simple. Cut the fish into pieces, the big fish into pieces, and fry according to the size of the frying pan. Don't narrow what God has purposed for you. Don't say, "My mom had a shop or a store in Upton Park, so we'll remain in Upton Park." Don't say, "My dad had a store or did a kind of a career that never went beyond anything, and you also want to do a career that was going to go beyond nothing." No. Dream above what you call your background. A wise man said, "Background means the back on which lies on the ground." No, you don't need to lie on the ground. Rise up, shake off that dust of belittling the dream God has given to you. Hear me today. It is what you see that you become. If you see greatness, if you dream greatness, if you speak greatness, you get it. If you speak poverty, if you speak shame, if you speak reproach, if you speak stagnation, if you speak frustration, then you will get all that. What you see, what I see, what I hear on a daily basis creates my dream. What you see, what you declare, what you speak determines what I see tomorrow. You're a product of your words. The words you speak on a daily basis, what you hear, the friends you hang around with determines the size of your dream. If you have friends who don't see a great future or dream of anything, the more you hang around dreamless men and women and boys and girls, you also will be confined to the kind of lifestyle they have. A wise man said, "Show me your future, show me your friends, and I will show you your future." So your future is determined on the friends and families you hang around with. Tell yourself, "I'll dream again." Shut it again. "I'll dream again." I want you to just pray a prayer point. That, "Lord, make me to see beyond natural. Make me see beyond what my parents see. Make me see beyond what I see. I want to dream again. big time. Lord, open your mouth and pray for yourself. Lord, make me see beyond what I see. Make me see beyond what my friends see. Make me see beyond what my parents see. I want to dream again. 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 A change of level. Not a frustrating dream. Not a frustrated life. But a dream gloriously well. In Jesus' name we pray. God will never dream for you. Do you hear that? God will never dream for you. And that's why many Christians are not making it. They love to pray and fast for 40 days, but not settling down to dreaming. Your fasting and praying is good, but when you spend more time praying and fasting and not thinking, because your thinking is that which will create a dream. If you're only done saying, oh, I wish I become a millionaire. I wish I could do this. I wish I could drive a Benz S350. And you're not walking towards it. You don't see yourself in it. You don't make an actualization of that dream by pursuing it. Then you're only wasting your time. You could fast from now till when you die. If you don't dream it, if you don't walk towards it, then it can become a reality. Don't get me wrong, it's good to fast and to pray, but you need to walk towards your dream. So they pray, oh God, prosper me. But hear me, God will not and will not prosper you beyond your dream level. Where I am today is somebody's dream. The microphone I'm holding today was somebody's dream. The clothes you're wearing, the designer's clothes, the CK perfume you're using. Whatever you see, the cars we're driving, the trucks, the aeroplanes, the sound system you love blasting, the ties, the shoes, the socks you're wearing, the panties, is somebody's dream. And he or she made that dream a reality. Because if the only just sat down and had it in their mind, or, you know, just went by and by with what was going on the earth, and they never had a dream that we could recreate or remodel some stuff that will help our generation, then they won't be in existence. I pray today that God's purpose in you, you and I, will not personally abort. In the school of sources, it is what you see, I repeat, that you become. In the school of sources, it is what you see that you become. God will never take you beyond what you see. Many don't see beyond the 9 to 5, and you want to become a multimillionaire. It's going to happen. You know, don't just do the talk. No. Settle down and think. And think. And have a picture of the scripture. And dream. And run with that dream. Christians are good talkers. But we don't know how to actualize what we talk. Until you begin to have a picture of the scripture and run with it, then you only live a life of frustration. Your 9-to-5 job is good, but if you want to be an entrepreneur, if you want to affect your generation financially, your 9-to-5 job, or working in an oil company, or working in an IT firm, 9-to-5, and you're so joyful of that £24 per hour, £25 per hour job, you can't, because you're confined to the office. If you want to make impact, you dream of you being self-employed, an employer of labor, employing others to work for you, then that's a dream come to pass. Many don't see beyond working 9 to 5. They retire, then pass on or die. You know, at 60, you know, I worked in British Telecom. I worked for blah, blah, blah. I did this, I did that. But what have you dreamt about? To see yourself employing people? Do you see yourself as an employer of labor? Abraham had 316 hired servants. He trained them and they were working for him. Isaac had men also. So, who are you emulating? If our life is just to come on earth, go to college or go to university, do 9 to 5, and 65 you retire, and go back home in a rocking chair and die, what effect have you done? Are you just waiting for 25 years of service in working for a firm or working for the local authorities and don't make impact? Or do you just think 9 to 5 job is what God has called it to be? No. If you really want to make quality impact in life, there is a dream you need to fulfill. There's a dream I'm fulfilling now. My dream is what I'm doing. In the past few months, I'm working to fulfill my dream. My dream is to see myself sharing the word of God with others, for young men and young women and men and women to live and actualize what God has proposed for them. Anything you see is what propels you. Anything you see is what propels you to become what you want to become. If you have a picture that you see yourself feeding thousands of children, then your whole body system begins to see, what can I do to make this dream come to pass? But if you don't have a picture of the scripture or a picture of where you want to become, there's nothing to propel you. You may have a vision, but if you don't see the dream becoming a reality, nothing propels you to become what you have seen. Yes, you could write it down on a paper and keep on confessing it. If you keep on confessing without having a picture of what you've written, then it can become a reality. You want a change of career? Don't just only talk it, do something about it. You want to become a preacher? Don't just say, oh, you know, I'm going to da-da-da-da-da-da. No. Do something about it. Take a step. They could laugh at you, but you know you started something. Every notable man and woman we're celebrating today. I love Colonel Sanders, a man who received 1,000 no. But today, we're celebrating his food. White creamy suit became creamish brown in his rickety, run-down Volkswagen car. Laughed at him by the bank, laughed at him by friends and family with his mom's made recipe. You could laugh at me today, but one day, write it down, you would hear, oh, that young man we used to see on www.mysweetfm.com is now a notable speaker, reaching out to millions. It starts from today because I dreamt about it and I'm walking towards it. Whatever you want to see today, you dream about it and walk towards it. God will never take you beyond the point of what you see. Hear me. God will never take you beyond the point of what you see. If you don't see it, God told Abraham, as far as your eyes can see, what do you see? I asked you that question earlier. What do you see in your future? Do you see yourself retiring at 65 and going to the nursing home? No. After Colonel Sanders retired from the army, it was $105 as his benefit for working or serving in the military. He looked at that money, which was not even enough for his what we call the benefit here in the UK, his social security money, and he asked himself, what do I have to do, or what can I give back to the society? That's a man with a dream. But I believe there are other men and women who left the military like him and spent the $105 on beer, on food, on clothes, shoes. A wise man said, he said, I prefer to spend $1,000 on my mind than spend $1,000 on shoes and clothes. Why? Because he has a future. If you don't have a future, then you cannot actualize your dream. Have a dream to bring your future into reality. Your generation is waiting for you. I'm walking in my dream. It could look lit today, but I've taken a step. Everyone we're celebrating today, McDonald's, Suzuki, Walt Disney of Disney World, every one of them, Thomas Edison, he failed 9,999 times. And they asked him, how come those bulbs didn't work? He said, I found a way that it would not work 9,999 times, because what, he had a dream, and a 10,000th time the bulb picked up. Wake up. Your world is waiting for you. Why are you listening to me today? Because I made up my mind to leave my full-time job and to do this full-time. Every dream starts from step one. Start yours. Make impact. Don't laugh at people's dreams because you don't have one. Wake up. God does not want to bless you. Let me put it this way. Many are not growing, not because God doesn't want to bless them, but because they have not dreamt anything. Many, I repeat, are not growing, not because God does not want to bless them, but because they have not dreamt anything. Why most of us are not being blessed is because you don't have a dream. Yes. Why most of us are not being blessed is because you don't have a dream. You're so settled, satisfied with that 4x4 bedroom of yours. You're so satisfied. Don't get me wrong. We will not ignore or celebrate our days of little beginning. It's a good one. But dream beyond. You can't be doing a job for 12 years, the same job, the same salary for 12 years. Think. Wake up. Your boss, your line manager, if you ask him or her, how did you get there? They'll tell you, I saw that position ahead of me and I walked towards it and I had a picture of myself sitting at that desk. Late last year, the Lord gave me this radio message team or tagged him, be inspired. At first, I did not see myself preaching on the radio or see myself coming on YouTube. But because I had a dream and God had seen my dream, my thoughts, I've been picturing myself. I remember every time I see Pastor Matthew Shimolo's name on TV, I take away Ashi and I put Olowo. Do you hear that? Every time I see Pastor Matthew Shimolo's name on TV, I take away the ashi and I write all over there. Why? Because I love what he's doing and I always see myself there. It was not possible a few months ago. But because I had a dream and God saw my heart pounding, preparing myself, I'm going to have a very good, vibrant message like other pastors, but the simplified message I'm telling you today is start somewhere. Start dreaming. Wake up. You are not going to settle for less. Frustration will not kill you. Depression will not be your portion. See yourself as an employee of labor. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you rise up again. The easiest way to paralyze a vision is to be dreamless. You could write on a vision, but if you don't picture yourself in the vision, then you're going to paralyze that. Because if you are dreamless, the dream or the vision, if you're dreamless, the vision will be useless. Dreams establish an expected end, thereby confirming God's word. Dreams establish an expected end, thereby confirming God's word. Whatever you want to be in life, dream. T.D. Jakes says how he started. Potter's House, Dallas, Texas, said he started preaching by looking at himself in the mirror. You want to get married? Start looking in the mirror and tell yourself, one day, a rich, blessed Christian who loves God and serves God with all his heart and might will marry me. Every day, keep on speaking. Dream about it, talk about it, look good, dress well, walk well. Don't drag your feet. Don't keep on moaning and say, oh, no one's going to marry me. No, wake up, brother. Wake up, sister. The best is yet to come. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. I love that scripture. God knows the thoughts. God is a thinking God. Why are you not thinking too? God thinks. God is a thinking God. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19 says, come, let us reason. So he's a reasoning God. Find time. Look, I love to sit in the toilet. It's quiet, clean, and I talk to God there. Find a place in your home. Lock yourself somewhere. The best place to lock yourself somewhere is the toilet, because no one's going to come in there when you're there. Find time and think. Find time, think and dream. Don't spend the whole time watching ABN, Nollywood is good. But can I tell you something? The people you're watching on Nollywood and ABN also had a dream that it'll be on TV. What's your own? Every item we have or we're wearing today or we're driving was somebody's thought that became a dream. Forget your background. Someone said, well, you don't know my background. You don't know where I'm coming from. Oh, please, wake up. If Colonel Sanders was looking at his background, we would not be enjoying KFC today. If McDonald's, the founder of McDonald's, was looking at his background, everyone we're celebrating, even great men and women of God like Kenneth Copeland, Bishop David Oedipo, David Buyeme, Pastor Matthew Shemolo, the founder of Keston Temple. Look at every great man of God, the late Archbishop Benson Idahosa, Pastor Iris Jaffo, all these men, if you look at their backgrounds, they came from nothing. But because they had a dream, Bill Gates, Donald Trump, think about all those great men and women of God. I pray we wake up. I just pray you wake up. He says, I think towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God wants your end to be glorious, so your thoughts create a dream. What God wants to see in you and me is we finish gloriously well. I pray again, nothing we are but God's picture of your dream. Nothing shall abort it anymore in Jesus' name. Where you are is not the final place. Where you are is not the final bus stop. Focus on your future. I remember a story shared by Pastor Matthew Shimolo in one of his messages, and he said the first sofa they had, he bought it on credit, and the kids were jumping on it, and every time they jumped on that sofa, his heart skipped. Oh. But today, he's a mega ministry. If he had screamed his head off and shouted at the kids and said, get off that sofa, don't you know that this is the only sofa we will buy, you will not be celebrating him today. Pastor David Ibirme got born again in 1996. His first prophetic offering was 50 naira. His prophet's offering, the prophet's offering he gave out was 50 naira. But he saw beyond giving 50 naira. The other day he was challenging us brethren. He had dreamt of giving a $1 million seed, which he dreamt and he finally fulfilled it. And I know he's doing more than that now. Everyone we are celebrating today had a dream, and that dream became a reality. You need to dream, and your dream will make you run and fulfill life. Every person you're celebrating today was someone, or anything or product we're celebrating today was someone's dream of yesterday. If you die without a dream, it's because you don't have anything to propel you. A man or woman that died without a dream is because you don't have anything to propel you. Anyone that dies without a dream is because he had nothing to propel him or to push him. When you hear a Christian lament and says, I don't know why I exist, know that such man or woman has no dream. If you have no dream that makes life, if you have no dream, life will become frustrated. Start to dream again. Your dream is a gateway to a life of sweetness. Your dream, my dream, is the gateway to a life of sweetness. Let's emulate those great men and women who today were clapping their hands and celebrating because they had a dream. We're going to go for a few minutes off the air, and when I come back, we're going to pray together. Remember, what do you see? And where do you want to become? Next 2 seconds, I'll be back on the air. Remember, Jesus Christ loves you. Amen. The word you've had tonight will stir you up again to dream again. It might sound harsh, it might sound not palatable, it might sound like what you don't want to hear. But what will profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Or what will profit you? You're born again. And you have 5 talents, you have 2 talents, you have 1 talent, and you're like the one man who had a talent and never did trade with it. Every man and woman of God in whom was celebrating Charles Wesley, John Wesley, Charles Spurgeon, Smith Wigglesworth, all these great men and women of old had a dream for this purpose. If you don't have a purpose, you don't have a dream. So purpose and dreams and vision equals to success. So if Christ did not focus on his dream or why he was sent to earth, there won't be millions of souls being born again today. I'm going to pray with you tonight because we're running out of time now. In case you're not born again or in case you've lost your passion for being saved. And tonight we're going to pray. Let's say after me, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Forgive me of all my sins. I confess you with my mouth that you are my Lord and Savior. I believe in my heart that you died to save me. And you were raised from the dead. Dear Jesus, come and live in my heart. Thank you for saving me. I am born again. Praise the Lord. Once you can wake up again spiritually, then I believe you will dream again. Don't wake up spiritually and wait for Jesus Christ to come. No. You'll be like that man in the Bible who hid his talent. I pray right now that whatever dream of yours that has been stagnated and frustrated will come back to life. I also want you this meeting to invite you to a very, very glorious program coming up next week, Friday, from next week, Thursday, straight on to Sunday, from the 8th to the 11th of October. It's titled Taking the Kingdom of God, Taking the Kingdom by Force. It's our 1 year anniversary for the City of Light Evangelical Ministries. We're celebrating our 1 year anniversary from the 8th to the 11th of October 2015. We have a lot of great men and women of God. We have Pastor Seth Gasu from Switzerland. We have Apostle Brian Kwame from the United Kingdom. We have Bishop Chipunze from Zimbabwe. And I, Femi Olo, will be the host of the program. We have Abby, one of the great minstrels in the kingdom. Also, we have Pastor, one of the great women of God also from Nigeria, who will be ministering to us here in the UK. If you need more information, you can call 075-330-7038, or if you log into the website of WWMySweetFM, you will see the handbill there on their website also. And also, you can also log into our website, www.colm.org.uk, and God will surely minister life to you. I want to thank you once again for giving me your attention. It's been a honor and a privilege to speak and share God's word on www.mysweetfm.com. I pray the Lord will bless this online radio station and minister life to you. I pray that everyone who is hearing me tonight, my God will visit you. And anyone who is going through any frustrating point, sick in the body, frustrated in life, I pray the healing power of God to touch you. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Remember, log in. From Friday, we will be shooting live on air of the program of the 1 year anniversary from 159 Corbett Road, Leytonstone E111JD. Please be free to join us. Come and hear God's word free of charge. The Lord bless you. And also log in onto the YouTube. When you go on the YouTube, you would see us clearly on there. The Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Amen. We'll be coming live on the YouTube channel. So if you log on YouTube on WWMySweetFM, you can go straight to YouTube. Just type in WWMySweetFM and you'll see a live broadcast coming straight down to your laptops, your PCs, and your iPhones. God bless you and have a blessed night. God bless you.
Life was nothing but a noise.